Hey everyone, welcome back to CryptoCash. Thank you so much again for joining me here. I hope you're having a phenomenal day. Quick look once more at ICP, double checking a few things here. We're respecting our ascending trend line here, being above the 20 and the 50-day SMA. A lot of positivity here. Okay, so again, I'm not just going to highlight the good stuff and be like, take it to the moon. But we'll also double check a few invalidations too, if that were to happen, what to look for. And just more so, you know, how to properly trade in the market. So we do get a lot of new viewers on our videos here, so I deeply appreciate you know, all the extra support, the newer subscribers coming over too. Don't forget to hit the like button on every video. Really helps grow the channel, gets us in front of more people. So, you know, less moon boys are destroying other people's accounts by saying that everything's just going straight up. While most altcoins are doing really well right now, you really got to be careful not to trade into overextension or key resistances, which we want to try to identify here. So when we look at liquidation, we want to talk a little bit about obvious areas. So there's pretty heavy concentrations to the downside. We can see that reflected on both charts. I'm not proposing we're going to see ICP drop to those levels just yet. We have to lose a lot of support and or trend lines first, but just know that it exists. $11 to $10 is that pretty heavy area that we have some high leverage long positions at. Okay, that's actually okay in this regard right now, as long as the delta doesn't stay too high. And let's go ahead and double check that too. It is fairly high for the moment, but it tapered off here recently, which is good. We saw some selling pressure, of course, when Bitcoin pulled down to that low 94, 93K range. All that being said, though, this liquidation delta is high, but it's not maintaining itself for too long. When we see this level for like 3, 4, or 5 days in a row, that's when we have problems. Okay. Again, most things come in threes. You'll see three strong green days followed by a fourth red day. A lot of that kind of ties into liquidation. If it's too high for too long, it's going to be a problem. For right now, it's not really that big of an issue. Let's take a quick look here at open interest and kind of see that the main areas of interest here for this coin is right about 13 or 12 and a half to $13. Okay, so it really reinforces that support level for us. So we see support at 1250 to 313, kind of reinforcing the fact that if the price were to pull back, we're likely to get a bounce off those levels. And again, 12 and a half is this guy right here, and 13 is right here. So we're seeing a support range right there in between that 0.236 and 0.382 Fib level. All right, so let's take a quick look at the daily. Work our way down now that we've prefaced that. In fact, let's go ahead and take a quick look at the weekly first and just kind of see where some weekly candlestick closures are. We're not there yet, but it's important to kind of add these to the chart just to give us perspective on some macro resistances. We can kind of see one right here as well, right there at about 1510, or just say round number of $15. We had 1, 2, 3, 4 weeks where there was a lot of difficulty closing above that level or below, depending on how you look at it. Anyways, those are just some areas to kind of pay attention to here. In other words, we're getting closer to a resistance range, and it's just important to notice that if we come up to that level, there's a decent chance we might see some difficulty, you know, increasing past that level, or maybe an initial rejection when we see that range hit. And $15 is also a round number. It's kind of like a, you know, 5, 10, 15, 20. It's one of those key level round numbers that a lot of folks will sell just because that's just a common characteristic in trading. That's exactly why you set Fib levels, or more importantly, sorry, set take profit targets just below. So 1499, for example, would be a much better take profit target than 15, because most everyone else is just rounding up, and it's just, you don't get filled if you have round numbers. It's just a common characteristic. Okay, daily time frame, where are we at? We're overextending on the RSI, but still in good shape. That's actually very good. This implies further upside, or more importantly, you don't consider closing your position because it's more likely to increase, right? That's a very good sign. We are, however, coming up to our second stochastic divergence, and that can be unfavorable because we have been moving up for quite a while here, so it does kind of reinforces the resistance at $14.50 to $15. When we look at TD Sequential, we're 5 days into this continuation. We likely have another 4 days of push to the upside. But just know that $15 mark is a potential resistance for us, and it would make sense for us to see somewhat of a retracement or initial rejection there. That kind of coincides with that stochastic divergence, but everything else is truly positive. I wouldn't read into that too much. Generally speaking, though, a stochastic divergence the second time kind of reinforces that. In other words, this was the first divergence. Second one is here. That kind of implies that, you know, we've pushed past that point of rejection, which is great, but we're also overextending for a second time, and commonly the second swing will carry more retracement than the first. So it would seem sensible if we lose this trend line for the price to come down to that, you know, $11 to $12 mark. Okay, again, just throwing it out there, those are the facts. It doesn't mean that it's going to happen. You shouldn't feel butthurt by what I just said. Okay. Having said that, let's go ahead and move on to the 4-hour time frame. SMAs are all looking good here, right? We're moving up well with the price action. As long as we stay above the 20, we have no cause to consider a short. Even once we get below the 20, it doesn't mean you're short. It just implies that we've hit our initial top, and it would make sense to presume the price may pull back a little bit. Same thing here with the RSI. We're under 70. This is fine. Good stuff. I like to see the RSI closer to 50 for that next potential pivot. But at this point here, I'll take what we can get. Stochastic is swinging down, and what the MACD is diverging. So generally speaking, these are all favorable signs, minus momentum, kind of letting us know that we're hitting, you know, somewhat of a shelf here, and we could see a potential pullback. When we take a look here, though, at the this ascending type of trend, it's going to have to discontinue at some point, but this is also very healthy, too. So again, this higher high, higher low pattern, it's very consistent, and we're not massively overextending ourselves. So it does imply that $15 would seem like a sensible next stop versus pulling back to a lower price point. You got to keep in mind, though, Bitcoin retraces significantly. We're going to see another correction. ICP wicked all the way down to 1285, for example, or 1290. When Bitcoin pulled down to the mid 93K range. So just some food for thought there. If Bitcoin pulls back, ICP will probably respond in kind. It may not be a dump, but it will probably be somewhat of a candle wick that we saw just now. Taking a quick look here at Ichimoku Cloud, we can recognize here as well, all green lights to leave your long position open. There's no reason to short or close because again, everything here is looking hunky-dory. So we're pretty much seeing mostly convergences on majority of timeframes. There's some slight potential for pullback based on momentum from the 4-hour of the daily, but I think it's still too early and premature to presume that's going to happen. I would pay attention to the pairing of ICP and Bitcoin and just recognize that Bitcoin's establishing lower lows and lower highs, and ICP is doing the exact opposite. If ICP starts to pair itself with Bitcoin, then at that point, we might need to shift our mentality a little bit. It really depends on if Bitcoin's going to break out or not. It's really trying hard to break 96K, and if it does, it'll probably be in better shape here. Most altcoins are probably going to continue higher. So good news is ICP seems to be inversely paired, where it's 2xing Bitcoin to the upside and only 1x or half x to the downside. That's a really good place to be. So my anticipation is that ICP will trend closer to $15 with the potential rejection there initially before it were to pull back. But again, I've been known to be wrong sometimes, so this is never an exact science, folks. The market is very, very volatile right now, so just, again, lower leverage, lower position size is probably the best thing you can do. I'll post a playout chart on our Twitter, Telegram, and Discord. It looks a little something like this if you're not familiar. I just give you kind of an overview of what I covered in the charts. And obviously, make sure you check out BitUnix, folks. No KYC or VPN exchange. This is the best exchange we've ever used as a community. $12,000 deposit bonus if you use my link to register. That's this month. Last month, we had a $60,000 prize pool. It's going to continue to grow as we get more traders. So great stuff. Thanks again. We'll look forward to seeing you on the next one. Have a good one. Take care.